and gentlemen, you're warmly welcome to study TCM from the Middle East area like Algeria, Libya, Saudi Arabia, Oman, Iran. Thank you for your trust to be here. Today, I would like to take such an opportunity to give you a lecture. The topic is Great TCM, the Luck of the World People. So, I would like to introduce two things. The first one is the medicine and the food are of the same source. Because in ancient time, people try to believe that the food and the medicine come together. For example, Chinese yen, as we told you yesterday, its function is tonify the spleen and stomach, enrich the qi, tonify the kidneys, and make people live long. So, this product could be used as food also. You see, in many types of Chinese yen. Another example is the lotus seed. Its function, tonify the heart, calm the spirit, strengthen the spleen and stomach, stop diarrhea. All these separate experiences summarized from thousands or dozens of thousands of years by thousands or dozens of thousands of people. So it's the result of the living human body. So all these separate experiences come together. So the herbal system come into being. Let's see, Western medicine. How is Western medicine produced? People, doctors research the rabbit, the hare, the toad. So they get the conclusion that this tablet could help this thing or help that thing. But so the Western medicine doctor, expert, announced very seriously that this tablet could help this problem, that problem. But 20 years later, they say that this medicine is harmful for this and harmful for that. So this medicine is stopped. So during the history, very few kinds of Western drug could live longer than 100 years. But Chinese medicine is 5,000 years old or more, and very reliable, friendly, and effective compared to the chemical stuff. Do you agree with my idea, doctors?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, thank you. So about the treatment of Chinese medicine and Western medicine, the result, I would like to give you an example. Hypertension. This patient has 200 more, so it's very high. So Western medicine, the way is to enlarge the blood vessel, promote urination to reduce the blood pressure. This is the truth. Pressure too high. So either enlarge or reduce the volume of the blood by promote urination to get the result of control blood pressure. So the result of the treatment is 10 years later. The patient has to get the dialysis because the kidney function and the liver function are totally damaged. So we say many people have to get the dialysis. So as I remember, 2.5 years ago, I visited Taiwan. So I see a huge hall, very huge, like a supermarket, and hundreds of machines like this are used. So it's a very terrible, bad thing. And if the dialysis for a few years and fail, so the kidneys has to be changed. On the other hand, Chinese medicine try to quicken the blood circulation, transform the blood stasis, clear the heat, expel toxin, so the root is treated. After 2 or 3 months, the original hypertension or secondary hypertension can be cured 100%. So no more Western drugs are needed. So, compared to this treatment method and the Chinese type of method, which way would you like? Friends, which way would you like?
The Chinese method.
Chinese way.
Okay, thank you. Abdullah?
Yeah, of course, this is the view.
Okay. So, many friends coming from the Western countries to me, they say that the theories and the treatment method and the materials to help the hypertension seems to be an endless disaster because the people has to suffer. They suffer from the damage of the kidney and the liver, and then they have to change their kidneys. And in recent years, you know many sad stories, like a young girl or young boy is killed because the patient need the kidney to change. Even though it's a legal way, people has to pay millions of Chinese yuan, dozens of thousands of US dollars to do that. So it's a disaster. So, last month, a group of Indian students, led by Mr. Raju, they get clinical practice and they visited the ceremony of the Japanese Second World War II. So, I tell them that a story. 1,000 years ago, there is a famous monk called Tang. Tang Sen went on a pilgrimage for the Buddhist scripture in the ancient time, 1,000 years ago. While now, your group from Arabic countries, you come here to take the classic of Chinese medicine back to your country. So I appreciate very much. Thank you very much. So it's a very famous the book and the story and the film. This is Monk Han. take the Monkey King. Yes, the four people, thousands of miles, go to India to take the Bible back. Today, your Arabic friends. So I hope you very successful. And so, in my personal feeling, that I am very much proud that ancient Chinese ancestors, they create such a scientific and huge system of medicine. They use their life to test the medicine, to verify the medicine. So you're welcome to study TCM hard, and I hope that one day among you will be world famous TCM doctors. You can help your local people very successfully. Thank you very much.